The early part of the afternoon was tense at Parliament as both the Deputy Speaker and the suspended MPs were lined up for a shutdown. The MPs backed by the opposition had declared they would not apologize as a precondition for their admittance into Parliament after serving their suspension of 3 sittings. In and around Parliament, there was massive deployment of both uniformed and plain-clothed police officers concentrated at the gates where the anti-riot police. Meanwhile, one MP at the center of the storm, Aru County's Odong Otoo, whiled away his time at the parliamentary gym.
And this is not the time for the faint-hearted. Those who are cowards, let them go back inside their mothers. We shall face these struggles squarely.
When the bell rang, signaling the start of the sitting for MPs, the opposition was still locked up in a meeting. Finally, when they made their way into the parliamentary chambers, some of the opposition lawmakers decided to evict some of the policemen who were deployed inside.
They cannot produce their identification papers. They cannot prove that they are staff of parliament.
When the Deputy Speaker emerged to chair the session, it was a different tone.
We have had discussions with the leader of the opposition, being what I am. And since I have found occasion to even apologize for things I have not done, sometimes just for the sake of peace, I have done that. And I don't feel any smaller because of being an apology.
For a man who insisted he would restore order to the house, there was a lot to explain.
And now that I have apologized on their behalf, I'll now allow them to come to the house so that we can proceed with the business.
Both the suspended MPs and the leader of opposition in Parliament, Nandala Mafabi, applauded the decision of the Deputy Speaker.
That shows democracy.
For me, I thank the blood in his body that stopped moving, because the other time he said we will not enter the house until the blood in his body stops moving. So we really thank the blood in his body for stopping to move that allowed us to access Parliament.
We all need these level-headed and cool decisions as leaders. Our role is at stake. We can't be leaders when we can't lead ourselves.
The standoff between the MPs and the Deputy Speaker kicked in motion when they sanctioned for misconduct during the passing of the Public Order Management Bill. It got off to a new high after the forceful removal of Chadondo East Member of Parliament Ibrahim Ssemujju-Nganda during a sitting. Many will be watching to see if the calm will return after the apology. Maurice Ochol, NTV at Parliament.